Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Sims 4 Stop Motion Speed Build. This is Megan, aka Simply Simmer, and I hope you're all staying healthy and safe. This week, I'm building Hershel's farm from The Walking Dead. With everything that's been going on, I found myself craving to watch The Walking Dead more and more, and I've also had several suggestions to do this build, so I decided it'd be a pretty cool time to put this build together. If you're new to my channel or just looking for something new to watch while you're adjusting to our strange new normal, I recreate houses from different TV shows and movies in The Sims 4. I have a lot of variety in my TV show genres, so consider subscribing to see if any of your favorite shows may come up in a future build. So anyway, I really love The Walking Dead, although I don't know if I can really be called a super fan because I haven't really watched since I think season 5 or 6. I'm not going to say any spoilers, but the last season I watched was the one that the really, really bad thing happened to Glenn. That was a really tough one to get over. But this farmhouse is so cute and it's really pretty too. I used one of the lots in Brindleton Bay since it's kind of in farmland. I thought it had a good scenic background. I'm really hoping for a farmer expansion pack in the future with like different farm animals or even yard work like mowing the grass or something like that. I like to play very realistically, so those would be pretty cool for me. I don't typically play with mods or custom content or anything. I like the game the way that it comes, but for this build, I did try to do something a little different, and I installed the zombie apocalypse mod for what's hidden in the barn. So make sure to watch all the way through to see the apocalypse in action. I was thinking about doing a Let's Play story with the mod, but I wasn't sure if it was something my viewers would be interested in watching or not. So let me know in the comments if that'd be something you'd like to see. The layout of this house was pretty confusing to me. I mapped it out according to what I was seeing on the show, and I think I got it down as smoothly as possible. There's still a few doors that I didn't really know where they led to, and there were definitely some bedrooms that were never shown on the show. When we get to the upstairs portion, I only showed off the rooms that were shown, so if you decide to download this build from the gallery, I left those rooms empty so you can decorate them for your Sims. This first bedroom is the room that Hershel operates on Carl after he was accidentally shot by Otis. Since the majority of this house is a classic farmhouse look, I thought about adding the IV fluid to this room to kind of set it apart from being the typical farmhouse bedroom. I believe that it's a debug item from the Get to Work pack. I think it'd be pretty cool to have an apocalypse pack. There are definitely a lot of preppers in the world, and I predict that it's not going to sound so bizarre and outlandish once we get through everything that's going on. I think it'd be cool to have a prepper sim who does canning and has an underground bunker. If you've ever played the game House Flipper, I think there is a free DLC that came with the game on Steam, and there are a bunch of prepper and doomsday type builds that you could do there. How fun would that be for The Sims? Maybe instead of a farmer pack, it could be just a doomsday pack that also comes with farming and all kinds of sustainable energy that would reduce bills or something. I don't know, I think that'd be really fun. But anyway, in the hallway area, there wasn't too much that I could see going on here from the build. There was one small shot of a side room coming off from the kitchen that had a desk in it, so I kind of used this extra space as what I imagine would be Hershel's workspace. Since he's a veterinarian in the middle of nowhere, I feel like there would definitely be times that people would bring their smaller pets to the farm to have Hershel check on them. I had thought about making a veterinarian office in the back, but the items that came with the cats and dogs pack didn't really match the theme of the house, so I left them out for the video, but maybe your Sim can be a veterinarian. Another thing that I think would be a cool addition would be to have home-based businesses again. I think it was Sims 2 Open for Business that you could sell things out of your own house. I really love that you can have businesses like veterinarian offices and restaurants and shops in The Sims 4, but I think it'd be neat to be able to do those from your own home. I feel like anytime I'm playing a Sim who owns a business, I never bring them home, so I always have some kind of housing situation attached to the business so they just stay at that lot forever. In the show, I did notice that there were some glass canning jars that they kept in the dining room, so I kind of created a little canning station there. They also had one electronic item shown, which was the TV, but I don't think it works anymore. Then again, they did have electricity for the lights and everything, so maybe it did work. Something I noticed about this house is how many chairs there are here. I mean, seriously, there's an insane amount of chairs. Pretty much every single room has somewhere to sit. As far as winding down after a day on the farm, there really isn't too much to do here except eat, read, or talk to each other. So I guess having a lot of sitting options is a priority to switch up your daily conversations in the apocalypse. But seriously, I only placed chairs where I saw them in the show, and there were so many, so I thought that was pretty funny. After Andrea grazes Daryl with a bullet, he does spend a little time recovering in this upstairs bedroom. And of course, we have chairs here so other people are able to sit by his side. When Hershel is treating him, he uses a wash basin to clean his head, so I used the wash bucket from the laundry day pack. There will be a clothesline out back when we head outside, so your Sims will have a place to dry their clothes if they use this to wash them. Also upstairs, we have another bathroom, and this is the one where Shane shaves his head as he reminisces on what actually happened to Otis. Okay, so we're just about to head downstairs, and I just wanted to take a second to let you know that I'm also on Facebook by either searching Simply Simmer or going directly to the URL of facebook.com/simplysimmer19. I do post teaser shots of upcoming builds as well as mini versions of my builds if you prefer to watch my videos at a faster pace. Or if you also like the casual chit-chat speed that we've got going here, don't forget to hit subscribe to my channel so we can stay talking. I love hearing feedback and suggestions from everyone, so feel free to leave a comment for me. Alright, so around the front yard I just put a few trees and the truck. I put a small pile of rocks next to the house. They didn't have a burial for Otis since there was no body, but they did have a memorial and stacked the rocks there in his memory. I also decided to set up the little campsite for everyone, so I made sure to put tents up and I couldn't forget the RV. But that just about wraps it up for this build. Make sure to stick around for the final walkthrough at the end so you can see the walkers in the barn. And don't forget to subscribe. See you all later.